This presentation has no problem with the proposed acquisition by Comelec. But I would like to again reiterate my concern with respect to the custody of the machines. I think to make sure that there will be less concern, less question, that the custody should not be with the Comelec, because if the Comelec would have custody of the machines, we would again be encountering the same concerns with respect to the custody of ballot boxes, etc., etc., in the past non-automated elections. The past elections, as far as I'm concerned, was well implemented with the people's machines of Smartmatic. I think most of us are here because of that. But this was during the time when the machines were in the custody of a non-Comelec entity. There was no human intervention as far as the Comelec was concerned. With due respect to the Comelec, I hope the Comelec will understand my concern here. I think it's even better for the Comelec to be insulated from the possible speculation that they may be tampering with the machines if the machines are in their custody. So if we can find a solution where the machines can be purchased, but not to be placed in the custody and control of the Comelec, then I think that will be more acceptable in general. Now, the other question I have is, we're holding this meeting, and we're listening to the proposal. I would surmise that we are here either on an advice or consent basis. Are we here on advice or on consent basis?
Well, we are actually conducting this hearing in order to find out what is the position of the Comelec and what do we expect from the Comelec, together with the possible steps which the Comelec may take in order to ensure a clean, honest, and orderly elections in May 2013.
Perhaps it may be generally advised if it would not entail additional appropriation. But if it could be a proposal that will entail additional appropriation, then of course Congress would have to be on a consent basis. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Well, just one legal question before we start, partner. Under the existing laws, the election should be automated in the May 2013 election. Will that be the correct legal assumption?
That is correct, Mr. Chairman.
So, under no circumstances will the election in 2013 will be manual. To make it a manual election, it is necessary that there should be some legislation or amendments in the existing laws.
That's true, Mr. Chairman, but it will also turn out to be manual if we encounter problems in the automated system. We are supposed to have an automated system, but if there will be problems encountered, where we will have no choice, extraordinary circumstances, where we will have no choice but to go back to manual, or even semi-manual, which means that there are proposals of an open election system, where the counting and voting will be manual, but the canvassing and consolidation will be automated. This is another option. But the law provides that it should be automated.
So these possible options, are they legally feasible without amendment of existing laws? Of course, we know that under certain cases, in remote areas or under certain circumstances, manual election might be an exception.
No, circumstances, Your Honor, where we will be forced to go manual, or at least the semi-manual, like the open system. If in the event that, let's say, that this option to purchase is found out to be no longer there or is illegal, and then we go into a public bidding for a new machine, and there are no bidders, or even if there are bidders, there are problems, they will not be able to cope with the RFP for the Commission of Elections, and there will be no bidders, and even negotiated bidding will turn out to be a failure, then we will have no choice but to go back to manual, which we can prepare for within a period of a few months before the elections. So this is extraordinary.
I think, if I may just interject very quickly, I think our role here is to make sure that we prevent the return to manual. I cannot understand why we're even talking of going back to manual when we had a very good experience with automated election. That would be a step backward into the medieval ages of the German. But may I just ask the response in German of the chair of the Congress with regard to my observation or with regard to my manifestation that for the sake of everybody, that they should not have custody of the machines. Is that a conceivable arrangement where Comelec owns but does not have custody of the machines? Custody and control.
Our problem is I don't really know, because if we exercise the option to purchase, then we have to take custody of the machines. First of all, machines would need maintenance, continue maintenance after the elections. So we're supposed to be handling. If we exercise the option of purchase, then Comelec becomes the owner of this machine. Right now, the ownership still belongs to the smart money. So they are the ones maintaining the warehouse. They are the ones actually taking care of the maintenance of these machines. They're spending for all of this. But once we exercise the option to purchase, then we become the owner. And we have to take custody. Or at least, not necessarily physically, but we have to take custody or possession in a constructively. I do not know who is supposed to take possession if we purchase this already and we become the owner. I mean, the Comelec becomes the owner. It is very difficult for us to say that we will not be in possession technically of these equipment which we have already purchased, but which we are already the owner. Right now, we don't have any possession of it except a few which we purchased already from Spartan. But once we exercise the option to purchase of the entire amount, the entire number of about 76,000, then we become the owner. My question only to the Honorable Congressman from my city, Paranaque, is that what is the issue on the custody by the Comelec?
The issue of ages, Mr. Chairman, that is the issue. The issue of ages, that is the issue.
Ages
going back to the time of Lapu-Lapu. I think the chairman is aware of this. We want to insulate the government from any speculation, accusation, that because this is a very sensitive thing, Mr. Chairman. Whoever has control of the machines can control it 100%, not like it's even easier compared to manual. In the case of manual, you have to control several key COC areas, let's say in a national election. But here, you can control it from one war room.
Now I can see that the issue of custody is apparently connected with the issue of trust or distrust. I don't know if I can guarantee it, but at least the Comelec, at the current composition of the Comelec, I think it would make the guarantee that there will be no abuse on the part of the
commission.
Chairman, one of the commissioners has gone on record in the past when he was not yet the commissioner of objecting to the smart market machines.
What would be our alternative? Who should be in possession? It will not be Comelec, and smart market is going to release it to the owner, who is going to hold cost in stealing the smart market.
This is where we can have a creative solution. For example, there are many instances in the present, here in the Philippines, and I think even abroad, where a government entity owns the equipment, but this is being placed under the control of a private contractor. course, this is not with respect to the consumption airports and even some transport equipment, where the equipment are on the back-to-back basis being placed under the controlling operation of the contractor, so that the government entity, the government personnel are insulated from the operation. The role is ownership, but control is given to a private contractor. That is the creative solution that may be possible, Mr. Chairman.
In the event, Mr. Chairman, Chairman Brillantes, in the event that the COMELEC should finally exercise the lease option, who will be the one operating the PCOS machines before, during, and after? Will it be COMELEC or still the smart money?
The operations, Your Honor, will be handled by the 40th Swiss members who are trained to operate these machines. They were the ones that operated it during the 20th century, just have to follow the same procedure, which means cost will be given by the BEIs. They are supposed to be the ones in charge of these machines. But actually, the hardware is supposed to deploy it in all precincts all over the country prior to election day. And then the one in control would be the BEIs, which are directly under the Commission of Elections. The matter of custody before deployment is the issue.
Yes.
It is now, right now, that all of these machines are in the warehouse of the Smartmatic, because we have not exercised the option to purchase. Once we exercise the option to purchase, then we take possession, physical or constructive, of all of these machines. The suggestion that we would give it to another private contractor to watch, I think would entail an additional expenses. Rather than that, I would suggest that if we take control of the warehouse where all of these machines are stored, I would rather suggest that all political parties be placed, put in patches in this warehouse where all of these machines are stored, so that they can watch until we deploy all of these machines all over the country and distribute it to all the different BEIs. So the matter of custody means custody now, as soon as we exercise the option to purchase, or and custody after or during election day. Custody during election day is with the BEIs. We're supposed to deploy all of this all over the country. It would be very difficult for the Commission of Elections to say that we are running the elections with full control and supervision over the elections, and yet we do not even have the possession of the main machine which is going to use. I think it would appear to be incongruous for us to be running elections, and yet we don't even have control over the machines that we have for the function.
The chair would just request to make a position paper on this morning with regard to the inquiry of Congressman Flores, including the legal issues that might be raised insofar as the custody is concerned, and of course the problem pertaining to trust and continents, because people might have trust in the present leadership of the COMELEC, but in rural areas it is quite a little bit different, most especially if there is a close association between incumbent officials and the election officials.
We will do that, sir.
Commissioner Sarmiento is recognized.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. This is connected with the point raised by Congressman Gomez and the response to our chair regarding custody of the machines. Now, there is, Mr. Chairman, in Section 9 of the Public Act 1969, which mentions the functions of the COMELEC Advisory Council. And among others, it tells us that the Council has the obligation to provide advice and or assistance in connection with the risk management of the machines. So possibly, to prompt a creative formula as suggested by Commissioner Gomez, I think we have to seek the input of the Commerce Advisory Council, composed of representatives from GOs and NGOs, to give us advice on the risk management aspect of these machines.
Mr. Chairman, I think that would be the better approach. instead of saying that we should trust 100% anymore. I think we have to be very defensive on this matter, Mr. Chairman. I trust Chairman Brillantes, but he's not the one who will have custody of the 75,000 people's machines. If he will be the one watching all of this, then I would say yes. But basically, that's impossible, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Commission, we recognize Perse Congressman Ginugundo.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is again further on the issue of custody. I believe the question